you're at 467 to 485 North Grosbeck Highway, Mount Clemens, Michigan.
Slow down in payroll growth. Weekly jobless claims are down below the critical 300,000 mark. We're talking a pandemic low, 293,000. The number of workers collecting aid is also down after the government wound up extended benefits that help ease the impact of the health emergency.
Lottery numbers at the top of each hour on WWJ. Today's Midday Daily 3, 335, to Midday Daily 4, 1434. Traffic and weather coming up in 2 minutes.
Sooner or later, we're going to get one of these. CRG Electric, because storms cause power outages, which brings spoiled food, ruined parties, no air conditioning, and other hassles. Make sure you're prepared for the next power outage before it happens.
Schedule your Kohler generator installation today. Visit us online at crgelectricllc.com.
CRG Electric.
Hello, this is Janice Winfrey, your city clerk, and as we approach the November 2nd general election, many of you are choosing to vote by absentee ballot. If you have not yet voted, visit one of our 13 vote centers and cast your absentee ballot in person. Vote centers are open Monday through Friday and the weekend before Election Day. If you have your ballot, do not mail it. Drop it off at one of our 20 drop boxes to ensure that it's received. Be smart. And vote like your life depends on it, because it does.
Wake up to Wendy's and get a bacon or sausage, egg, and Swiss breakfast croissant for just $1.99. Made with fresh cracked eggs and served on a hot buttery croissant that's fluffy enough to sleep on. It's time to Wendy Wakey. Hit the Wendy's drive-thru and get your bacon or sausage, egg, and Swiss breakfast croissant for just $1.99. That's a better breakfast for just $1.99. Only at Wendy's. We got you.
Get that satisfying crunch. Now with 20% more honey. Try a delicious Nature Valley Oats and Honey Crunchy Bar with more of the honey you love.
Now there's another way to listen for the latest news. Ask Alexa to tune in WWJ. His watch never stops. News Radio 950.
And weather together on the 8th Street to McCaskill.
Checking the AAA jam. Kim Sears still watching a slowdown. 94 eastbound from I-75 to Van Dyke. The left lane is blocked. Delays ongoing southbound I-75 between 14 and 11 mile. And northbounders dealing with the delays here, especially between 8 and 12 mile. Just one lane open each way for the brake lights for north and southbounders here between Sibley and Will Carlton. And still a 90-minute delay for commercial vehicles coming into the U.S. along the Blue Water Bridge. That's traffic from the St. Joseph Mercy Health System Traffic Center.
AccuWeather meteorologist Dean DeVore says our high today near 79, still humid. We do expect some showers and thunderstorms later today. Tonight's low near 61, and then tomorrow mostly cloudy and not quite as warm as it has been, with showers, even a thunderstorm tomorrow. Friday's high near 67, Saturday's high near 58, and then Sunday we'll see a bit of sunshine, the high near 62. Right now it is partly cloudy, currently 79 degrees downtown. Brooke Allen, top stories ahead with Jackie Page and Tony Ortiz.
Charges from the state of Michigan filed in two long-standing cases, including the nearly 40-year-old disappearance of a baby girl. I'm John Hewitt.
And the manhunt for alleged child rapist is over. We'll have those details coming up. And the Big Three are out with their vaccine requirements. Autobeat reporter Jeff Gilbert will have those details. The rally continues on the market, and a big night for the Red Wings. They open their season at Little Caesars Arena tonight. We'll check sports. Now CBS News covers the world at 2 o'clock.
Rates and deaths are declining.
It's important progress, but it's not
now's not the time to let up. We have a lot more to do.
Mr. Biden says the number of unvaccinated Americans, now 66 million, is still unacceptably high. He repeated his call for businesses to impose vaccine mandates and said parents should ensure their kids get the shots.
Everyone who hasn't gotten vaccinated, please get vaccinated.
Stephen Portnoy, CBS News, the White House.
President's words come on the same day the FDA is meeting to discuss the use of booster shots. The head of the FDA's Center for Biologics Evaluation and Research, Dr. Peter Marks, says boosters are eventually needed.
The vaccine effectiveness against mild and moderate disease does appear to wane over time for the different vaccines.
A prominent South Carolina attorney has been charged with stealing insurance settlements meant for others.
Alex Murdoch was arrested at a drug rehab facility in Orlando, Florida, accused of keeping $4 million in insurance money from the sons of his late housekeeper. He's been at the center for 6 weeks since he claimed he was shot in the head by a man while changing a flat tire. But police say it was a scheme to get life insurance money for his son. There's also the unsolved murders of Murdoch's other son and his wife. He says he found them shot to death in June. Wendy Gillette, CBS News.
This just in, the January 6th panel is now pursuing criminal contempt charges against Steve Bannon for not complying with a subpoena. The congressional committee will vote next week to recommend the charges, and it could eventually make its way to the Justice Department to decide whether to prosecute. The State Department's calling for calm and de-escalation in Beirut after heavy fighting claimed at least 6 lives and left dozens others wounded. Reporter Dale Gatlach is in Amman.
Lebanese analyst Joseph Bahut warns today shootings in Beirut are a sectarian threat.
The country is now on the verge of maybe something very great. Lighters on the rooftop that are shooting at both parties protesting in the street.
Interior Minister Bassam Malawi says many of the casualties were shot by snipers from buildings, calling this a very dangerous sign. Dale Gavlak for CBS News, Amman.
Coming to London's West End. Stand up, the Bob Marley musical. Previews are underway. The official opening set for next Wednesday. The Dow's up 528. This is CBS News.
Today, better nutrition and great taste are more important than ever. That's why Eggland's Best gives you and your family more. And that's healthy news for everyone. Only Eggland's Best. Live and local. Detroit's number one news station. News Radio 950. Tony Ortiz.
And I'm Jackie Page, and it's our top story at 2:03. The state attorney general announcing charges today in 2 longstanding cases in our area, including the 2014 death of a Ferndale man at the former Northland Mall. WWJ's John Hewitt joining us live with the latest, John.
Yes, Jackie, it was January of 2014 when 25-year-old Mackenzie Cochran became involved in a physical altercation with security guards at the former Northland Mall. Multiple witnesses that day told police that Cochran, as he was being handcuffed, repeatedly said he could not breathe.
Members of the Southfield Fire Department responded to LA Diamond Store at 5:57 p.m. When they arrived, Cochran was sitting on the floor, handcuffed and unresponsive. The department attempted to revive Cochran with smelling salts, but to no avail.
U.S. Attorney General Dana Nessel today announcing involuntary manslaughter charges against 4 of the 5 surviving security guards in this case. They're identified as Lucius Hamilton, John Sieberling, Gavin King, and Aaron Marie. In the other case that the attorney general brought forward, it dates back to the 1982 disappearance of a 9-month-old girl, Alyssa Williams, who was taken at the time by her stepfather, Isaiah Williams, and believed killed in what Nessel today called an act of control over her mother, whom he allegedly abused for years. Williams, who is not the biological father of the child, is in custody in Illinois fighting extradition efforts, I should say, on the charge of open murder. Reporting live, John Hewitt, WWJ News Radio 950.
Detroit police say a suspect is in custody, wanted for the abduction and rape of a 9-year-old Farmington Hills girl on Sunday. Police in both Detroit and Farmington Hills are investigating the incident. Here's Farmington Hills Police Chief Jeff King.
I want to thank Chief White and his staff for their commitment to this interagency investigation and will result in the eventual prosecution of the individual responsible for this horrendous crime.
The girl was approached by the suspect in a Jeep Renegade offering help when she got in the vehicle. He took her to a home on the west side of Detroit and raped her. The girl managed to get away, and a good Samaritan who saw her called 911. Stay with WWJ as we get information on this developing story.
Detroit's automakers are announcing their first vaccination requirements. We have more now live from WWJ AutoBeat reporter Jeff Gilbert. Jeff.
And Jackie, that new vaccination policy in Canada, all three of the Detroit Three will soon be requiring salaried and manufacturing workers there to be vaccinated, as well as visitors to their facilities in Canada. Unifor President Jerry Dias, who represents Canadian auto workers, tells Canada CTV that he won't be fighting these policies.
Players that come out with a mandatory vaccination policy in front of arbitrators.
Here in the U.S., the car makers would have to negotiate any vaccination requirements with the UAW. They say these policies they announced today only apply to Canada. Reporting live, I'm Jeff Gilbert, WWJ News Radio 950.
The FDA is meeting to determine if emergency authorization should be granted for a booster dose of the Moderna COVID-19 vaccine for those who are 18 years of age and older.
The Moderna booster dose would have half the vaccine compared to its regular vaccine. Dr. Anthony Ogin is an infectious disease expert at McLaren Macomb Hospital.
Most new vaccines require a booster, and they're usually three-shot series. People shouldn't be surprised if they're figuring out that they need a booster. The different thing with COVID is that we're looking at this virus in real time. We're gaining experience with this virus and figuring out that do we need a booster, when is the booster to be given. And you really can't compare this virus, the COVID virus, to other viruses.
The FDA will meet Friday to discuss a booster dose for the Johnson & Johnson COVID-19 vaccine, as well as mixing and matching different brands of vaccines. From the Delta Dental Health Desk, Dr. DeAlice, WWJ News Radio 950.
Michigan has another $6 billion left in American Rescue Plan money. A coalition of 40 businesses, government organizations, and statewide associations called the Coalition for a Strong and Prosperous Michigan has ideas on how that money should be spent. Steve Curry is executive director of the Michigan Association of Counties.
The pandemic forced states to issue stay-at-home orders, which led to massive layoffs, business closures, and unprecedented levels of unemployment. To address these issues, we believe that we should invest another $800 million to enhance revenue sharing for local units of government, stabilize the unemployment insurance trust fund, and provide technical assistance for reporting and compliance requirements related to the American Rescue Plan.
Other proposals include spending more than $1 billion for water infrastructure and replacing lead service lines and $125 million for PFAS mitigation.
Coming up in 2 minutes after traffic and weather.
A new Chick-fil-A opening in Michigan.
5 minutes in line, the best ever, and I don't have to go to Toledo ever again. Amen.
I'm Charlie Langton.
By the way, you'll notice Charlie did not bring us any samples.
I think he's very excited about that. WWJ News Time is now 2:08.
Charlie's never excited.
Right?
Time now for traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the 8th with a check of traffic. Here's Tracy McCaskill.
And this report sponsored by Phillips Sign and Lighting. Checking the AAA Jim Kim Sears. Still the slowdowns for the work along westbound 696 from Middleville to Farmington Road. This moving work crew is still in your left lane. Left lane blocked as well on 94 eastbound from I-75 to Van Dyke. And the delays ongoing both north and southbound I-75. Southbounders dealing with the biggest delay from 14 to 11 mile, and the route from 8 to 12 mile is the slowest here for northbounders. Until 3 p.m., the work continues 94 eastbound as well from 10 Mile to Frazo. And again, along the Blue Water Bridge, drivers seeing more than an hour-long delay for commercial vehicles coming into the U.S. and about a half an hour delay if commercial vehicles headed into Canada there. That's traffic from the St. Joseph Mercy Health System Traffic Center.
This afternoon is going to be mainly cloudy, very warm, highs in the mid to upper 70s with some showers and a thunderstorm. More rain and some rumbles tonight as we end up in the low 60s, and we'll stay in the upper 60s, showers and even a thunderstorm tomorrow. It's turning chilly with some rain, heavy at times, and maybe a gusty thunderstorm tomorrow night, the low near 50. Windy, much chillier Saturday. We'll stay in the 50s with showers at least through early afternoon. Back to some sunshine, breezy on Sunday with a high getting up in the low 60s. And then we'll moderate into the mid-60s and upper 60s for a couple of days next week early before another chilly shot comes in next week, mid to late next week. I'm AccuWeather Meteorologist Dean DeVore, WWJ News Radio 950.
And it's mostly cloudy and 76 degrees right now in Ann Arbor. In Pontiac, mostly cloudy, 74 degrees. Mostly cloudy and 77 in Mount Clemens. And at Detroit Metro Airport, it's mostly cloudy and 78 degrees.
WWJ News Time 210. There's heavy traffic today downriver as the newest Chick-fil-A location.
location opens.
A lot of people are very happy about the newest Chick-fil-A opening here on West Road in Woodhaven. Now, they only have drive-through service only, but it's not that long wait, so people can get their Chick-fil-A. For people that have never had one, Mike Schuchman, he's the developer of the project. How would you describe a Chick-fil-A sandwich?
I don't know if that's safe for radio for me to describe it. No, it's, I mean, you give that first sort of bite into a chicken sandwich, it's plump, it's juicy, kind of reminds you of your youth, your childhood. I mean, that's really sort of the effect I have when I get a Chick-fil-A sandwich.
There's a lot going on there, Mike. Anyway, it is the grand opening here at Woodhaven. Again, the lines are not too long, so come on in and enjoy the newest Michigan Chick-fil-A in Woodhaven. Charlie Langton, WJ News Radio, 950.
Drivers who need help crossing the Mackinac Bridge will be paying more for that service. The driver assistance program, which was suspended because of coronavirus, will resume on November 1st. The Mackinac Bridge Authority decided today to begin charging $10 per trip when the program resumes. The cost will be increased to $15 per trip beginning in January of 2025. More than 2,500 people used the service in 2019. People who are being driven across the bridge will have to wear a mask.
The Hope Network officially opening its newest center for autism today in Livonia. Former Detroit Lions kicker Eddie Murray works with the Hope Network, and he says this new center will provide some much-needed help for parents and children in our area.
We're one of the larger organizations that offer early diagnosis autism services in the state of Michigan, and we're very excited for the new one in Livonia because it's now down in southeast Michigan where the population is greater, there's more need down here, there are more services that need to be provided for autistic children in the Tri-County areas.
The facility is located on Newburgh Road in Livonia. It's on the campus of Madonna University.
Being bullied or harassed at work can sometimes be an expensive double or even triple whammy.
There's been plenty written and talked about concerning sexual harassment on the job. Studies show it can result in a lifetime earnings hit for the people involved. The Time's Up Foundation and Institute for Women's Policy Research studied this, determining that sexual harassment survivors could lose in the end in dollars and cents, big time. There are losses stemming from harassment, maybe retaliation, that can include reduced earnings, lost bonuses, promotions, maybe a job loss, and then there are other costs, lack of retirement contributions, health care, legal fees, forced career changes, the cost related to re-entering the workforce. When it's all said and done, people who survive sexual harassment on the job could lose as much as $1.3 million in lifetime earnings and benefits, according to the Time's Up Foundation and Institute for Women's Policy Research. I'm Murray Feldman, WWJ, News Radio 950.